knowledge.
சார் நீங்க எங்க தானே இருப்பீங்க? என்ன ப்ராப்ளம் வந்துச்சுன்னா கொஞ்சம்
ஹலோ குட் மார்னிங்
குட் மார்னிங்
ஆம் ஐ விசிபிள் மை பொசிஷன் இஸ் கரெக்ட்
No, turn on your video.
Yeah, wait. Yeah.
No,
your position is not in a correct
manner. Is.
Is it okay?
Keep your mobile in down with the help of some things.
Is it okay?
No, at the back side, some window is there. It's very glare.
Okay, ma'am. I'll close that. Is my position is okay now?
Oh, Monisha.
How should I adjust?
Wait. Yeah, ma'am, now it's okay, no, ma'am? Ma'am, please unmute yourself. I'm not hearing you. Please unmute yourself, both of you, ma'am and Monisha.
Yes, Ajira.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, now the Monisha's position is okay, I think.
Yes, okay. The same position while you speak.
To maintain.
Yeah, okay.
Minus correct, Hajira?
It's okay. Ma'am, sollunga, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
My position is correct?
Yes, ma'am. Both of his position and voice is clear. Position is also okay.
Okay, where you connect Harshini once and Shida?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, Harshini is not in this meeting, I think.
Shall I call her?
Yes, ma'am, call. Not if she joined, I think.
Okay. Harshini joined the meeting, ma'am. Ajira?
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I call principal, sir?
Okay, ma'am.
Or otherwise, I will call VP,
ma'am. Now the time is 10:20, ma'am. You informed, ma'am. You informed to sir and ma'am.
Okay.
Then we'll start. Monisha, while you are speaking, maintain the same position.
Okay.
Now you can turn off your video.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Am I audible?
Yes, yes, you're audible.
Okay.
But for now, you can unmute yourself.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இன்ட்ரக்ஷன் கொடுத்துட்டு தென் மகாமன் வெல்கம் ஸ்பீச் சார் இப்போதான் ஓகே மேம் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிட்டான்னு கேட்டேன் மேம் ஓகே மேம் ஓகே மேம் கேட்டுட்டு ஓகே மேம் நான் morning to all. It's my pleasure to welcome you everyone. Today is the second day and our guest is S. Monisha, RTI and internee at Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education, Chennai, Kodi. Let's start our day with the blessings of God. It's time to have a prayer now. So now I invite Ms. R. Mahalakshmi, PG Department of Foods and Nutrition, to address the welcome speech. Please, ma'am.
Hajira, I cannot start my video. Good morning and a very warm word of welcome to everyone. On behalf of PG Department of Foods and Nutrition, Marudhar Kesari Jain College for Women, Vaniyambadi, it's a great pleasure for me to welcome you all for 2 days webinar on Perspectives of Health and Nutritional Trend 2020. I feel honored to welcome our Secretary Sir, Shri C. Lakshmichan Jainji and other trust members in absentia. Welcome you all. I extend my hearty welcome to our beloved Principal Sir, Dr. T. Balasubramanian, who always encourage and support us in all the activities we do. Welcome you, sir. It's my privilege to welcome our Vice Principal Ma'am, Dr. M. Inbavalli, who always motivate and guide us. Welcome you, ma'am. I extend my heartfelt welcome to PRO Ma'am, Ms. B. Shaktimala. Welcome you, ma'am. I consider it's a great honor to welcome our today's guest, Ms. Monisha, RD internee, Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education and Research, Porur, Chennai. Welcome you to this wonderful occasion. I'm fortunate to welcome all the heads, faculties, and students of various departments. Welcome you all. Finally, I would like to welcome my department faculty members for their continuous support in all the activities we do. Welcome you all. Once again, I welcome you all for today's session on the topic Immune Boosters to Combat Invisible Pandemic COVID-19. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Now I request Ms. Harshini, Assistant Professor, Department of Nutrition, Food Service Management and Dietetics, to introduce our today's speaker. Please, ma'am. please, ma'am.
Good morning to everyone. Before anything else, preparation is the key to success. It is a great pleasure for me to introduce our alumnus speaker, Ms. Monisha. She completed her UG in Mardar Kesari Jain College for Women, Vanyambadi, batch 2015 to 2018. She has pursuing her MSc Clinical Nutrition and Registered Dietitian Internee in Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education and Research, Chennai. She published a paper on the topic anemia in Sundance International Journal of Management publication in 2016. And also she actively participated in the 7 days camping program on the theme of Swachh Bharat in Tirupattur. She did her MSc 6-month project in effects of flaxseed supplementation for cardiac vascular disease patient. Today she will talk about the human booster, which is very important during this pandemic period. Now that time to hand over the session to Ms. Monisha. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Now the session is Monisha's yours. You can start your video. Monisha, please turn on your video.
Yeah, yeah. Can you share the screen?
Yes, yes, I will share. Please adjust your phone.
Yeah, yeah.
Adjust your mobile.
Okay. Is it okay now?
Yeah, yeah, it's okay.
Yeah.
Is it visible?
Yeah.
Monisha, slide is visible?
Yeah, yeah, slide is visible.
Okay, now I can start.
Yeah. A very good morning to one and all who present here. First of all, I would like to thank the management of Mardar Kesari Jain College for Women and a principal, sir, Dr. T. Balasubramaniam, sir, and vice principal, Dr. Ingavalli, ma'am, and head department of nutrition, FSM and dietetics, Mahalakshmi, ma'am, and the faculties of other departments who and all joined. A very good morning to one and all who gave me this opportunity to join as a speaker in this webinar. I'm going to talk on immune boosters. Next slide, please. Before move on to the topic, as you all know, let food be Thai medicine and medicine be Thai food. Next slide. Yeah. Previous slide. Yeah. How it works, medicine is a compound which has quantized and frequency to the same, on the same way, if you select your food to quality and quantity and also in frequency, it works like a medicine. Next slide. Here we'll see how our body immunity works. These are the layers of the immune system where immune cells, it categorized into four: leukocytes, granulocytes, lymphocytes, and phagocytes. Leukocytes. Under this leukocytes, monocytes. Monocytes, regulates the immunity against foreign substances and neutrophils, where it plays a key role in the front line defense against invading pathogens. And basophils, it fight against parasitic infections, which plays a role in preventing blood clotting. And it contains heparin, which is a natural occurring blood thinning substances. And lymphocytes, it is nothing but it is primarily involved in the body immune response mechanisms and plays a vital role in production of antibodies. Moving on to granulocytes, it is categorized into three: neutrophils, basophils, and eosinophils. As we already seen, neutrophils, basophils, and eosinophils is nothing but it modulating the inflammatory responses in the body. And lymphocytes, these are the two major cells, B cells and T cells, which plays a vital role in immune system. B cells, it plays a role in mediating the production of antigen specific immunoglobulins, which are nothing but antibodies. T cells, it recognizes foreign antibodies and kill the infected cells, and it can also act as a helper cells which interacting with B cells and maturing them to producing the antigens. And moving on to phagocytes, it is categorized into four: monocytes, neutrophils, macrophages, and mast cells. Mast cells is nothing but it is serve as the functions in the body and central nervous system, such as affecting or regulating allergic responses and autoimmunity and inflammations. Then moving on to types of immunity. As you all know, there are two types of immune system, innate immune system and adaptive immune system. Wherein the innate immune system plays a major role in preventing the spread and movement of the foreign pathogens throughout the body. And wherein the acquired immune system, it is composed of specialized systemic cells and process that eliminates pathogen by preventing their growth. And comes on to the innate immune system. It is a non-specific and rapid. It is a physical, it acts as a physical barriers, biochemical mechanisms, inflammatory responses, phagocytosis. In the adaptive immune system, it is highly specific and slow process. It consists of B cells and T cells. B cells, which plays a role in humoral response, and T cells, which plays important role in cell mediated enzymes and cytokines. And next we'll see on antibodies, which is nothing but immunoglobulins. There are four types of immunoglobulins: IgA, IgD, IgC, and IgM. Next slide. This is a common and vital thing everyone should follow: a balanced diet. A balanced diet is an important because our organs and tissues needs proper nutrition to work effectively. Without good nutrition, our body is more prone to diseases, infections, fatigue, and poor performance. And here I want to quote a thing: is every single food has a special nutrient. No single nutrient is a magic nutrient. So every nutrients are vital in our body in their major roles. And here I want to explain about healthy eating plate, which consists of 3/4 portions of the vegetables and 2/3 portions of the whole grains and cereals, and 1/3 portions of the green leafy vegetables and other portions of the fruits. And in the same way, we have to maintain adequate fluid status, as well as liquid drinks, as well as fruit juices and some other hydrated drinks. Next slide. Yeah, we are moving on to immune boosting nutrients, which is nothing but it enhances our immune system and protects from the various diseases, infections, inflammations. And these are the nutrients which plays a important role in immune enhancing effects in our body: vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin A, vitamin E, vitamin D, iron, selenium, zinc, folate, vitamin B6, and vitamin B12. We'll see each one of the nutrients, how it play and how it works in our body. Next slide. Vitamin C. The recommended dietary allowance of vitamin C in our body is 40 milligrams per day. Vitamin C is otherwise known as ascorbic acid, which plays a vital role in defense mechanism and the formation of protein used to make skins, tendons, ligaments, and blood vessels for healing wounds and forming scar tissue, for repairing and maintaining cartilage, bones, and teeth, and aid in the absorption of iron. Vitamin C deficiency results in impaired immunity and higher risk of infections. So vitamin C plays an important role in our immune system. These are certain foods which are good sources of vitamin C, which is amla, guava, orange, capsicum, raw mango, red amaranthus leaves, and lemon juice. Here, there are specific roles, such as it promotes a collagen synthesis, which is nothing but it maintains our tissue, bones, cartilages, ligaments, tendons, and teeth. And it reduces a free radical damage. And it also plays a vital role in antibodies production, which is nothing but immunoglobulins, to serve as an immune effect. And it improves antimicrobial effects, and it plays an important role in phagocytosis, which is nothing but it is a process by which a cell engulfs a particle and digests it. Next slide. Yeah, move on to vitamin A. The recommended dietary allowance of vitamin A is 600 mg of retinol and 4,800 mg of beta carotene. Vitamin A also involved in the development of immune system and plays a role in regulating to the cellular and humoral immune response and major function is a good vision. And here, these are the certain foods which are the good sources of vitamin A. Carrot, pumpkin, egg, fish such as mackerel fish, and chicken, liver, and green leafy vegetables. And here there are specific roles which are, it serves as a major function as potent antioxidants, anti-inflammatory property, combat free radicals, production and development of antibodies. And the beneficial role for vitamin A is for eyes and skins, bones and teeth. It maintains the good vision and it helps in improves immunity as well. Next slide. Vitamin D. The major biological functions is to maintain normal blood levels of calcium and phosphorus and aids in maintaining strong bones, as you all know. And sources, there are minimal sources of foods and it present in dairy products. And the another source which we get naturally through sunlight exposure. And these are the dairy products such as milk, buttermilk, curd, paneer, cheese, etc. And these are the specific roles. It acts as antimicrobial properties, healthy gut microbes, reduces pro-inflammatory cytokines, and promotes antigen processing. Next slide. Previous slide. Vitamin, no, previous slide, previous. Previous. Previous, previous. You're going next. Go to previous. Previous, previous. Next slide, next slide. Next slide. Next slide. Previous slide. Yeah. Vitamin E. It plays a vital role in maintaining healthy skin and eyes and strengthens the body's natural defense against illness and infections, which is nothing but the immune system. And it is a potent antioxidant. These are the certain foods sources which are available for such as sunflower seeds, garden cress seeds, flax seeds, nuts and seeds, almonds, pistachios, and spinach. Mostly it is present in nuts and seeds as well as in green leafy vegetables. Here there is a specific role for the vitamin E, which act as a antioxidant. It prevents free radical damage, enhances the T-cell mediated functions. It plays a vital role in cell integrity and cell mucosal membrane as well. Next slide. Vitamin B12. Yeah, vitamin B6. It is also termed as a pyridoxin, which is a water-soluble vitamin that plays in several functions in the body. It is significant to protein, fat, and carbohydrate metabolism. And here there are food sources, nuts and seeds, whole grain cereals and millets, and pulses and dals. It is rich in vegetable sources, and it is good source of Banana is a good source of vitamin B6. Here there are specific roles, reduces inflammation, amino acid synthesis, and metabolism cytotoxicity activity. Next slide. Yeah. Vitamin B12, which is a water-soluble vitamin that is naturally present in some foods. And there are minimal sources of the plant sources, and which is abundant in the animal sources. And it is required for proper blood cell formations, neurological functions, and DNA synthesis. These are the sources. And the plant sources, such as dairy and milk products. And in the animal sources, it is present in chicken, fish, liver, and eggs. And here there are specific roles. Gut microbiota, immunomodulators, intestinal immune regulation, T cell proliferations. Next slide. zinc. I couldn't see the RD requirement. Can you go to slideshow? No, no. Ah, yes. I couldn't see the. Yeah, zinc. The recommended dietary allowance for zinc for adult male is 12 milligram per day and for female 10 milligram per day. Here, we'll see the functions of zinc. It is a vital nutrient for normal development. It plays a role in cell division, cell growth, own healing, and breakdown of carbohydrates. It plays a major role in body's defense mechanism. And these are, here are some food sources such as almonds, soya bean, whole grain cereals and nuts, and garden cress seeds, chicken liver, eggs. And the specific roles which played in our body is skin and mucosal integrity, anti-inflammatory, maintaining immune system, and it has an antioxidant effect as well. Next slide. Yeah, selenium. It is also a major micronutrient which plays a role in preventing cell damage, and it produces a special protein which is antioxidant enzymes. And selenium deficiency leads to weaken the immune system and alter the host response to viral infection. The recommended dietary allowance of selenium is 40 mcg per day. And here there are food sources, egg whites, and chana dal, moong dal, chicken liver, fish, broccoli, and various certain foods. These are the sources which are a good sources in selenium. And moving on to the roles, it also acts as the same antioxidant activity. It plays a vital role in immune enhancing effect as well. Next. Yeah, magnesium. Magnesium plays a important role in the synthesis, release, and the activity of cells of the immune system. And it plays also a major role in innate immunity as well acquired immunity. Deficiency of magnesium associated with impaired function of both humoral cell mediated response. And recommended dietary allowance for magnesium for adult male 350 milligram per day and for adult female 310 milligram per day. And here there are food sources. Magnesium are good sources of green leafy vegetables, almonds, garden cress seeds, and sunflower seeds, and proteins and dats. And here there are specific roles which act as an antimicrobial effect, supports a healthy immune system, maintain normal nerve and muscle function. Next slide. Yeah. And probiotics and prebiotics. These also play a major role in immune enhancing effect. Probiotics, which is nothing but, it is a good microorganism which enhances our healthy gut system. And here are some of the food sources such as asparagus, wheat bran flour, garlic, and banana. Prebiotics is, and certain food sources are yogurt, prebiotic milk, sour cream, and kefir. These are the fermented products which are helpful in improving our gut system. Next slide. And here's the significance of immune booster. And immune boosters plays a major role in stimulate and maintain our immune system. And there is the basic use of immunomodulators is to keep us healthy and functions of the body normally in a proper manner. And various nutrients which plays a specific role in immune enhancing effect, which we already seen in a detailed manner, such as vitamin A, D, C, B6, B12, folate, zinc, copper, selenium. And it plays a synergistic role in every stage of immune response. Adequate amount are essential to ensure a proper functions of physical barriers and immune cells. However, the daily micronutrient intake necessary to support immune function may be higher than the current recommended dietary allowance. So at least a minimal amount of the immune boosters foods should be included in our diet. That plays a major role in our maintaining our healthy immune system against foreign substances and pathogens. Next slide. Yeah, and these are the foods which are the kitchen based foods which we use daily purpose in our daily life. Ginger, mint leaves, cinnamon, cloves, turmeric, garlic. These are the major anti inflammatory effect, and these act as an antioxidant as well. And these are the commonly available foods which can use in a daily purpose in our drink, as well as in milk, as well as in some drink, in some food varieties, or in daily our food lunches and breakfast as well. Next slide. And this is some research article. Pharmacological activities of cinnamon tamala needs and its medical implication. In this article, they have done an in vitro study, and in this article, they have taken cinnamon leaf extract against the leaf extract for a study, and they have find out the denaturation of the protein. And the current study shows there is a significant anti-inflammatory effect in the protein denaturation, as well as it has a synergistic activity of immune enhancing effect rather than a single compound. It is not only a single compound present in the leaf. It has a major role which they have found out through this study. Next slide. And phytochemical constituents and analysis of orange peel. Orange peel also has a major role in immune enhancing effect, and in this they analyzed the proximate phytochemical constituents which helps in modulating our immune system, and they find out the biological activities by inhaling and using some of the techniques. They find out that orange peel has a good immunomodulatory effect in our body. Next slide. No, previous slide. And here is one more article, immunomodulatory effect of Vitania somnifera. That is nothing but ashwagandha. As you all know, it is a commonly name of Vitania somnifera. And this study they have done under rats, that they have find out that there is a significant increase in total count of WBC, ALC, and platelet count after the ingestion of this ashwagandha leaves after the 5 days. And the findings investigate the therapeutic potency of ashwagandha toxicity produced during cancer chemotherapy by mitigating of bone marrow depression. And it also helpful in the anti-cancerous property, which plays a role in during the cancer chemotherapy treatment. Next slide. And here I have given some immune boosting drink, which you can try on a daily basis, not only during this pandemic crisis of this coronavirus. You can daily implement in your life, which will enhance your immune system. And these are some ingredients which are all rich in anti-inflammatory property, antioxidant, and anti-enhancing of the immunity. And lemon juice as well. We have to take as a squeezed lemon in a like half lemon or full lemon, and turmeric powder, which also has an antibacterial activity and antiviral property, and ginger, anti-inflammatory and antioxidant, mint leaves, cumin seeds, crystal salt, and pepper powder. And this, we have to boil all the ingredients together for 20 minutes and have it regularly in a smaller quantity, which is around 50 to 70, 75 ml. Because of the tolerance, if every individual, there is a different mechanisms in our body which plays a vital role. So we should try in a minimal amount. After it tolerates to our body, you can include up to 100 ml. And this can be taken in the morning as well in the evening. which is convenient timing for you. And while you are taking in the evening, take in the night time before sleep, and make sure after that you should not eat anything or drink anything. Next slide. And one more immune boosting drink. This ingredients include cinnamon, ginger, pepper powder, cumin seeds, as well honey and lemon. These also are good immune boosting drink, which plays a vital role in our body to strengthen our immune system against the foreign bodies. Next slide. And here. Thank you. Is there any questions would you like to ask?
Thank you so much, Monisha. Thank you so much. It was very wonderful presentation and very informative.
Thank you.
Okay. It was very informative. Any tips for your juniors?
Tips,
advice?
Yeah. I'll suggest. First of all, they need to have a balanced diet. And these are the general tips I would like to share to my juniors. And they should maintain balanced diet, which constitutes each and every food groups. They should not skip their breakfast. They need to maintain their food intervals properly. And they need to maintain the hygiene properly. And as well, they can try to implement this immune drink, which will work out in your enhancing the immune property. Because I tried practically myself, it worked out on me. So you can also try. And there is no side effect because these are the natural food sources. So you can close your eyes and try implementing this. It will really work out in your body to strengthen the immune system as well. And one more thing I want to tell you, stay safe and don't go unnecessarily outside unless and until it's an emergency, and maintain your health properly, taking all the food groups, all the nutrients which and all I have quoted today as a immune boosters. You can try to implement at least one food sources of the one nutrient. At least in a vitamin A, you can try to include carrot. In vitamin C, at least you try to include amla or some other food sources, which is convenient and which is available in your area, wherever you stay. Yeah, that's what my suggestion.
Thank you, Monisha. There is another question. What is the causes of low immune system and which age the immune system start weaken? What is the causes of low immune system and which age the immune system start weaken?
Yeah, the first cause is inadequate intake of the nutrients, of all the major macro and micronutrients as well, and inadequate eating pattern and what else?
Okay, there is another question.
How
can we boost our immune system very fast?
We can daily implement these are the micronutrients, because micronutrients play much role rather than the macronutrients, because micronutrients has a each and every effect properties of strengthen the immune system. So daily, if you implement these food sources under the minimal quantity, not in the recommended dietary allowance also, it will strengthen the immune system. As well, in the instant to increase the boosting rate in your immune system, you can try with the immune drinks and some recipes like immune enhancing foods, which include like salads, which includes these properties, and you can you can include as a fruits and juices and drinks as well.
Thank you, Monisha. Thank you so much. And you want to share your college experience with your juniors?
College experience, yeah, I'll share. Yeah, we have seen so many cases in my master's in Ramchandra Institute. We have seen so many cases regarding the immune weaken cases also. Like there is a low immunity power in them, and especially in cancer patients. I have seen many cancer patients, they were in very cachexic state due to their inadequate intake and due to their lower level of immunity. So initially we will suggest the patients with a general dietary guidelines, and after we'll monitor each and every day how their parameters are increasing, as well in hemoglobin level, as well WBC count, platelet count. Then if it is not if it won't improve or work out, we will make a separate diet plan which consists of each and every immune enhancing properties, and they will suggest to the patients, they will implement on a daily basis, then and we'll see the improvement after the 15 or 20 days of the follow-up, because in the initial days we won't get the such improvement. So each and every patient will adapt these nutrients and these pattern of the food plan, diet plan. It will take little time because they were following the different diet pattern. They were very inadequate in their food intake. So we will initiate in a gradual amount to take all the food groups. We'll recommend the commonly available food groups and low easily available and low cost food recipes that they can easily implement on their daily basis, because the socioeconomic status also is one of the reason that they couldn't achieve their maintain healthy body weight. So the one thing is, we will suggest the patient for all the balanced diet first, and trying them to making them to initiate and implement in the gradual amount in the in the initial state. We will tell in the slow process, then we'll try to make them to eat well, and we will initiate a separate diet plan, and we will see the improvement, and we will daily monitor the patient in a daily basis, and after that we will monitor throughout the follow-up till the patient get discharged, throughout the follow-up, and then we'll see the parameters on the discharge rate. They will improve a little much, because in the hospital setup we couldn't implement much sources, because they will they are not much convenient to get all the food sources, and in the hospital setup also they won't provide such a food items in the menu, like in the diet menu, in the morning and lunches and the dinner. They won't provide such a different types of menu which we suggest, because they follow the scheduled diet. So it will make difficult to maintain their health status in a initial stage itself. So it will take time for us, and it will be challenging for us to see the various cases, especially the cancer patients, as well as in another comorbid condition like diabetes, renal patients. Every cases will be challenging, but the way we initiate the step, that plays a major role. So according to the condition, according to the body metabolic energy demands, we will initiate the diet plan, and we will increase their requirements, as well as we will suggest the different food sources, and we modify the diet as well. They don't if they are failing to follow the diet pattern, and if they are not convenient with the diet which we plan, we modulate the diet, and we'll see the difference between this the previous sample diet which we gave, and we after the modulating the diet, how it improves. So most of the patients, we have seen much improvement in their health health status, and some of the patients which we fail to see the improvements in the initial stages as well in the after the discharge status also, like after 15 days or 20 days follow up also, because every individual have a different mechanism process in our body. So it will be great challenging to us, and we have seen many cases like renal patients and cancer patients and like diabetes, hypertensive, and every other patients follow a different lifestyle pattern according economic status. It is a great challenging that making convincing to the patient is a great challenge to us. After convincing, we can easily implement whatever we want to improve their health status. So these are my few experiences which I faced, and which these are the challenges I faced. But in the during the discharge time and during the end follow up of the status, we can see each and every improvements in every parameters as well in the body composition also, in the stages of weight and skin fold thickness and MAC level, everything changes will be a little, but we can improve the status. Though initially we can't improve, because I told you before, they will follow the different pattern and different food pattern, different mindset. They and one more reason is, and we are facing the challenge according to cultural and belief. Some people are very strict to the cultural and beliefs, so it will be a great challenge to us to convince their these thoughts to change into the food pattern. And this one is the major challenge, and the, another one is to convincing the patient into the different food pattern. This will be the one more changes that I face difficulty in convincing the patients. Otherwise, we can manage. Actually, we have the power to improve the health status. As a nutritionist, we can modulate, we can improve, we can implement, we can make sure that we will give a good, best results to the patients. And in our hand only, we have that quality to improve the patient status as well, and the patient development also.
Thank you, Monisha. Thank you. And your experience in MKGC?
MKGC? Oh. Yeah. MKGC, I have learned so many experiences. It was a first journey of my degree. So I have seen many people's major new people's and new set of the exposure. It gave me a different exposure. And our faculties, our nutrition, FSM, dietetics faculties, as well my head of the department. She is a person who always encourages and motivates me. Though I feel low, she will makes me to do this and to do that work, to engulf in different varieties of activities which was conducted in the department. So I feel very grateful to my HOD ma'am to give this opportunity as well to improve my career and to motivates me, to guide me always. And as well as my faculties also, other faculties, they also helped me to motivate and guide me to improve myself. And regarding my seniors and juniors, I have learned many things in their thesis works, in their academic works, and in their studies works also. And even they also don't hesitate to talk with us. They are very friendly, and they share everything to us like as a sisters. They share as a notes, they share some other things, they share some other opportunities, some other activities in other departments too. So I feel very grateful to my seniors also. And as well to coming on to the juniors, on my set of batch, I have I have quite a few juniors which are very familiar and close to me. They are very good, and they try to understand whatever I will explain to them, and they will give more ideas to me. Usually will tell no, we have to learn some other things to the juniors, because learning is a thing we can do in throughout our life, because we are not much enough with our theory or practical basis. Learning is a daily part of our life. So they have shared me many experiences. They have shared me in many ideas and points to overcome with any programs and any other problems, everything. That's all.
Thank you, Monisha. Thank you so much. Your presentation was very wonderful and very informative. Thank you so much, Monisha.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Is there any question?
Thank you for your wonderful presentation.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I feel really happy today that PG Department of Nutrition, Food Service Management and Dietetics come to the conclusion part. That is a vote of thanks. It's my great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this memorable occasion. Let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's occasion to the resounding success. First and foremost, I would like to thank our management who has given this opportunity to conduct this webinar. Thank you, sir. Gratitude is not only the greatest of virtue, but the parent of all others. I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to our principal, sir, Dr. T. Balasubramanian, for being the catalyst that stimulated us to our best and standing pillar strength. Thank you, sir. I would also like to extend my thanks to Vice Principal, ma'am, Dr. Yam Inbavalli, for your continuous encouragement and guidance. Thank you, ma'am. And it's my pleasure to thank our PRO, ma'am, Ms. B. Shaktimala, who has motivating and supporting for conducting this webinar. Thank you so much, ma'am. Confidence and hard work is the best medicine to success in life. I would like to extend a very heartfelt thanks to distinguished guest speaker S. Monisha, RD and internee at Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education Research, Chennai, Porur. Thank you, Monisha. I would like to give a sincere thanks to all the head of the department faculty members for attending today's webinar. Thank you all. It's my pleasure to thank our HOD ma'am, R. Mahalakshmi, for her moral support and guidance. Thank you, ma'am. I also extend my special thanks to our organizing committee member for this enormous cooperation and teamwork for this webinar. Thank you, ma'am. Finally, I would like to thank all of the students for the dedication and support. Finally, I thank our technical team member for the cooperation at the end of the session. Once again, I thank you all. Thank you so much for your cooperation. Thank you all. Feedback form is posted in the chat box. It will work for another 1 hour. Thank you.